The rest of City Council is getting a chance to weigh in on possible changes to the trash pickup system in Oskaloosa. The issue has been in the hands of the Public Projects Committee. After six meetings on the garbage situation, the committee turned to a council work session for input.
The three council members who sit on the Public Projects Committee, Joe Caligiuri, Aaron Versteg, and Tom Walling, explained why they chose to reject some of the suggestions made by last year's University of Iowa study on trash pickup. First, that every resident must have a licensed hauler pick up their trash.
And the feedback I was getting too, some people prefer to take their own trash out, which is fine, you know, down to the county dump. I just feel very uncomfortable that you're forcing everybody in town to say, okay, you will have a hauler, period.
Next, that the city should enforce a single hauler system where the same garbage company picks up everybody's trash. The committee didn't want to move forward with a single hauler, at least right now.
The other thing I think we questioned was trying to keep everybody busy, trying not to put anybody out of business. I think we all agree that free enterprise is the way to go.
City Manager Michael Schrock reminded the council that a single hauler system could offer more services. Things like yard waste and bulk trash pickup and curbside recycling, all while reducing garbage truck traffic.
A study from the University of Iowa showed that towns around us that had gone to the single hauler were very satisfied and were getting the service and more service for less money. Is that correct,
yes,
Michael?
Yes, ma'am. That's correct.
In the end, the Public Projects Committee is suggesting a series of code changes to help solve trash problems. The first is to require people to take out their trash every 7 days. The current city code states garbage can't be left in public view for more than 30 days, at which time the city can issue a warning or citation.
Well, we tried to eliminate some of that uncertainty and provide a little more clarity in the sense that it has to be picked up once a week.
The other changes define what types of garbage cans can be used and where they can be put. For example, you can't have a car parked in front of your cans or garbage piled next to your cans. Councilmember Jason Van Zetten found the changes too restrictive.
I definitely don't want the hauler going to the customer saying, the city told us to do this and this is the way it's going to be. And, you know, one of the problems that I have is the trash that has to be in the container. You know, if I got more trash than that, did we create more of a problem? And the hauler goes, hey, I'm only going to take what's in the trash and everything else is going to sit out here.
Schrock says in those cases, the haulers still can pick the garbage up. They would just now have the city's support through the stricter code to address repeated problems.
Again, this is written to help the collectors have to deal with cars that are blocking. And if they don't pick up, they've got something to say, look, there's been a vehicle that's blocking your trash can. I'm not picking it up.
The council will have another work session to further discuss possible changes to the city code. A date for the meeting has not been set.